Andrew looked at the cello with a certain disdain and paused to reflect. He had hated the cello ever since he was a little boy. His father used to beat him with his cello whenever Andrew did something his father considered wrong. Here, today, now, his father was horribly drunk and terribly furious.
Oh my God, no.
Andrew looked from his father's menacing eyes to the motionless cello leaning against the corner of the room and back again. The cello cost a small fortune, and each time the man beat his helpless son with it, it broke into thousands of little splinters of wood. And each time he bought another one to do it again the next morning.
Oh my God.
It was the most cost-effective method of punishment known to man. The last thing Andrew had done to anger his father was to spill orange juice on his father's favorite bright white carpet. It was an accident. He didn't mean to do it. But that did not change the unsightly orange that soaked into the brilliant white background. His father wasn't home at the time. There was still a slim chance for Andrew to not get his ass beat to a bloody pulp with a cello. He tried frantically everything he could think of to get the stain out. On the internet, he looked up how to rid a carpet of an orange juice stain and found only one post in some long-forgotten carpet enthusiast forum that looked promising. The username was rugmuncher6942069. Half of the post was written in what seemed to be gibberish, or some sort of secret code. The other half revealed that the only way to remove orange juice from a white carpet was to smother it with pure jankum. As Andrew read these last words, his heart sank a little, and he became crestfallen, entering in a state of utter despair. Being a veteran jankum consumer, Andrew knew that it took at least a week to fully ferment to its mature state, and he didn't have any already made.
Oh, no.
His last hope shattered. He recalled the hundreds, maybe even thousands of times his father had taken the cello to him.
Oh, no.
He rubbed his scarred buttocks in remembrance of the excruciating pain. He suddenly felt a surge of some new energy, accompanied by an idea that lifted him out of his despondency. It occurred to him that if jankum removes stains, that perhaps fresh human waste possesses some of the same properties. A sly grin appeared across his face as he said to himself, he'll never know the difference.
That's crazy. It just...
When suddenly a problem with his plan occurred to him. I have to poop, but it's completely solid. Not the best for smothering. What he needed was plenty of syrupy brown goop with a low viscosity.
Oh, God.
His mind instantly traveled through time to the Thanksgiving when he ate all of the contents of his grandmother's largest pickle jar. It contained pickles and nothing else. Bingo, he said. The secret to explosive diarrhea. He dashed nervously to the pantry, hoping that the ancient artifact was still there and that it hadn't been thrown out. His family had this one pickle jar for many years that was just collecting dust in the pantry. He got there and he threw open the door, and there it was, on the back shelf. He removed the lid and began devouring the jar's contents faster than is humanly possible. About 100 pickles later, he began to notice this strange feeling around the middle of his body. He relocated from the kitchen to the living room, where the carpet was, and removed his clothing. Here goes nothing, he said nervously. As his father entered the front door, Andrew bent over and squatted. He bent his knees, which loosed a small stream of anal seepage,
oh, God.
Followed by a mighty free-flowing river of mythic proportions.
Oh, no.
But this was just the calm before the storm. His father entered the living room to see his son bending over, nude and knee-deep in an ocean of liquid excrement that covered the floor of the entire room. Andrew turned towards his father, whose face instantly became crimson with rage. Fear gripped the heart of the vulnerable young man, whose face turned white as a sheet in anxiety, then became contorted in pain. The lower half of Andrew's body suddenly exploded from the pressure built up inside, from all the pickles, of course, leaving the top half intact. As this was happening, one of the bones in his exploding leg happened to impale his father in the chest, wounding, but not killing him. With the force of the explosion, the top half of Andrew's body landed on the couch in the next room. He had become unconscious when he hit his head on the ceiling in the blast. The cello turned around of its own accord, drew his weapon, an extra-large, golden desert eagle, and said to Andrew's bleeding father in a deep voice,
"You killed my whole family. Prepare